afternoon, everyone. It's good to be here. Let me quickly share my slide. So once again, artificial intelligence or AI, you know, nowadays has been interpreted differently so vastly. Everyone have a different interpretation. I mean, if you look into my kid, you know, they think AI associated with robots like Transformer, Gundam, or even Iron Man. And the teenager nowadays, like you guys, who think AI is important in Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok to make you look good. An engineer will think about AI with Tesla, Rocket, or even Skynet. You know, my wife will think AI is very, very important in Netflix because it can recommend the right Korean drama for her. If you ask a professor in mathematics, he will say AI is just a bunch of algorithm for optimization. And business owner believe AI is important for them to make more money, right? Well, I mean, all are correct at some point. According to Techopedia, AI is an area of computer science that emphasize the creation of intelligent machines that work and react like humans. So, I mean, in the other words, AI is just try to mimic a human. For example, human can see. In AI, we have machine vision. I mean, we can talk. ENI here, this speech recognition or text to speech. We are the thinker. ENI, we call it expert system. Human can read, can write, and for AI, it called natural language processing. For human, we have the ability for pattern recognition and matching. I mean, such as, for example, to know roughly how cold is this room right now. This is based on our past experience. In AI, we call it as a machine learning. Humans have a self-learning capability where we have a thousand of neurons in our brain doing just that. In AI, it's called deep learning, where it uses neural network, a series of structured algorithms imitating the way that neurons are fired in our brain. I mean, this neural network model can be trained, I mean, for example, to recognize handwriting, face, or emotion. And then we have also, as a human, we have the mobility. You know, we have leg, we have hand. It allows us to move around and to do our daily job. This in AI, we call it robotics. I'm sure that you have heard these three terms before many, many times, the machine learning, deep learning, and also the robotics. If you look into this report from Harvard Business Review, there are three types of AI application that support the business need. And they have studied about 152 projects. Out of the 152 projects, 47% of them are actually for process automation. This is a very common type of AI. It is the least expensive and it easiest to implement. It brings a very quick and high return on investment as well. I mean, for example, it's a robotic, automated report generation, and also spam filtering. The second is called cognitive insight with about 38%. It is a machine learning application and use algorithm to detect patterns. One of the key features is extreme personalization. This is commonly used in social media, e-commerce, such as Facebook, Shopee, and even in finance. And finally, you have this called cognitive engagement with about 60%, where this type of AI allows you to engage with customer or employee, such as using chatbot, service robot, natural language processing, and so on. You know, nowadays, user want fast information. I mean, now look into this. Is AI our friend or foe? I mean, the usage of AI is broad. It has been used in many different industries from our daily life, banking, retails, all the way to space industry. It sounded that, you know, AI has brought a great deal of benefit to us as a friend, right? Not so much in harming us as an enemy, right? I mean, I'm going to show you some example cases of some are AI as a friend and some are AI as could be our enemy. Let's start from the first one, AI as our friend. There is no doubt that AI has been used widely in our daily life. You know, sometimes we don't even realize it. One example, the moment we are at home, we have smart home controlling our home to our preference, such as the lighting, the temperature, and even the security. We have also used Alexa or vacuum cleaner, you know, for convenience. Then when we go to work, we actually use Waze to guide us to our destination without getting stuck in the traffic jam. Google search engine helps us to search information in seconds that require days in the past. And you know, then we have this spam filtering system in email. It's also a form of an AI. Then when we do exercising, socializing, and entertainment, we use all kinds of AI devices and applications. For example, the smartphone, smartwatches, you know, those that actually measure your heartbeat and all kinds of social media that we have. This is Atlas Humanoid by Boston Dynamics. It's one of the most advanced and dynamic humanoid at this moment. It has all the sensors, super intelligent. It can balance itself and move like a human. It can run, do parkour, and you know, do flips like this. I don't think I can do that. Well, I mean, yeah, just amazing, right? I'm sure you have experienced this yourself in product recommendation. If I bought stuff from e-commerce such as Shopee and Lazada, we keep seeing, you know, recommended item to recommend you what to buy. For Amazon, 35% of the total sales are resulted from the recommendation engine. And for Netflix, the interesting fact is that 75% of what you watch on Netflix are actually recommended by AI. This is a bank in Brazil, Bradesco Bank, has about 65 million customers. They have trained an AI chatbot powered by IBM Watson to answer 283,000 questions in a month. So in some cases, the response time reduced from 10 minutes just to seconds. Amazing, right? I mean, try to imagine that right now the bank does not need to hire so many operators to handle answering questions. So this reduced the bank operating costs. And more importantly is that they have a bunch of very happy customers that lead into the lead of a business growth. This is Compact Rehabilitation Robot, or CR2. It's a robot to assist physiotherapists for a more efficient rehabilitation on stroke patients. So here again, this CR2 is designed to mimic a physio, as we don't have enough physiotherapists. The patient is holding the robot as if the physio is holding the patient. So the robot has haptic and virtual reality technology. So haptic means it allows the patient to have a touch sensory as he or she is being held by the physio. You know, it uses game also to motivate and make the training more exciting. CR2 was actually started from a university final project. Yes, it's from a final project. You know, this show even undergrad nowadays can have the capability to develop advanced robotic system that could serve the society. And what was happening recently in Malaysia, actually during the first lockdown due to COVID pandemic. At that time, I think we all know the situation was tense with high infection rate, shortage of PPE and lack of workers. Then a robotic startup in Johor, DF Automation, has developed Machika 19, MCK19, a healthcare delivery robot in just 17 days. This robot can move autonomously to help the hospital to deliver food and medicine. You know, this reduced the usage of PPE and also to reduce the risk on infection. So it has served together with the nurses more than 53,000 meals at the Tantri Hospital at MIT. This is also an illustration that the development of AI and robot now can be much faster compared to the past with the current available technology. Well, I mean, as much as AI has greatly benefited the society, you know, unfortunately, AI can bring harm as well. The first example of the harm is obvious, and many are very, very worried about it, to be honest. AI will create job loss and unemployment. According to a McKinsey report, it is estimated that up to 800 million jobs will be lost due to automation by 2030. Well, I mean, this debate is fun, right? But yet it's scary. If you are aware now, all the videos of former President Barack Obama are all fake. You know, he looks and sounds very realistic. Deepfake, unfortunately, has been used for crimes such as for politics, pornography, fake news, revenge, and even financial fraud. AI is biased. It's simply because AI is developed by human beings. As we humans, we make error, as well as we are biased by nature, you know, due to our difference in upbringing and also culture. So there will be some prejudice during the development of the AI. These biases, including the gender hiding algorithm, flawed criminology software, Facebook ad algorithm, and also racing. Another case of AI being an enemy is actually the data breach and social manipulation. One of the recent cases that shake the world is the infamous Cambridge Analytica data scandal. This was a serious data breach of about 87 million users were improperly accessed. This Cambridge Analytica has provided assistance to president campaign in USA. He was also widely accused for interfering with Brexit in the UK. This is scary, right? I mean, try to imagine your preference of your political choice is due to this manipulation without you actually knowing it. I mean, this is a world that we are currently living in. Sometimes we are unsure what is real and what is not. I mean, the next round, really no need for grand introduction, the autonomous weapon. A country doesn't need to risk their people at all for the war. They simply send this autonomous weapon. If this falls to the wrong hand for the wrong purposes, a lot of innocent life will be at stake. Scary, right? I mean, if you look into this, AI is actually just a tool, just like a knife. It's a double-edged knife. It can bring good as well as harm. If the chef is holding the knife, that will be beneficial to cut vegetable, to make great food. No doubt about that. But if the knife falls on the wrong hand, that could misuse it to, you know, to rob and harm people. I mean, however, AI, you are not able to see whether it brings good or harm, so obvious. I mean, it's not that obvious, right, sometimes, or maybe most of the time. For the knife earlier example, you could see the chef, the robber, and even the sharp and dangerous area of the knife. But for AI, you're not able to see at all. There is no obvious sharp and dangerous area. You don't even know who is the programmer. You know, I mean, the programmer could purposely put some serious bug inside the, you know, the application that will only happen after 1 year. Or it could be the user who used a friendly AI for destruction purposes. So it makes AI even scarier and dangerous. I have shown this earlier, one of the examples of AI in our daily life. These AI are great. It helps us tremendously from the moment we woke up, working, exercising, socializing, until we all went back home, right? However, one of the possible disasters could happen if we allow AI in our life without control. AI will take our intelligent role, one of the very reasons why we are still in this world. There will, you know, a robot to help us to work. We have AI to look after our healthcare, and we have tons of different AI to look after tons of things. And even in the future, you know, our husband and wife could be a robot as well. With that, what is the reason for our assistance? We might as well sleep 24/7, 365 days throughout our life. I mean, even Elon Musk had made this bold statement. AI is far more dangerous than nuclear. So, ladies and gentlemen, so what's next? There is no doubt that AI is important in our life. I mean, and has played a very important role and will continue to do so. But it has to be within a controlled manner. If you are an organization who is going to develop the AI, please make sure the intention is for greater good for mankind. If you are a programmer, then we need a policy, law, or even a world treaty to govern AI development or ban those AI that will harm humanity. And finally, to all of us as a user, we need to use it with care and responsibility to ensure AI is good, is used for good. You know, AI is here to stay. Friend or foe, it is our responsibility. Thank you very much.